Hi guys, today in this video I would like to show you how to use the Sitefinity file manager tool to manage the file in your project. Okay, so basically when you deploy the code to the Windows server and maybe sometimes you don't have the remote or credential to access the server where hosting the website. So if you have some small change regarding to the style sheet, JavaScript or something like that, so how to do it with the quick change? Instead of waiting for the approval to accessing into the hosting server, so you can do it over the Sitefinity backend. Okay, so let's get started and working with this. Okay, so this one is the Sitefinity backend, and you have to make sure log in into this system by the administration account. Okay, so under the administration here, you click on this and scroll down in the tool. We have the file manager. Click on it. Okay. So here you can see we have the coding folder structure on the hosting on the server. Okay, so I will open the IIS server and see. Yeah, you can see here the folder structure on this is the folder structure on the server hosting by IIS server, and this one is the folder is displaying over the Sitefinity backend. It should be the same. Okay, so for example, for now you want to have a small change for a style sheet, or you want to just change a small for JavaScript. And you just go ahead to open the folder. For example, this one is a folder which contains okay, so for example, the readme.txt is a CSS file on your system. And you just go ahead to download this file, select and download it. Yes, it will download it into the system. So all. You are able to download the multiple file from the server, but in this video I just download only one file. You open the CSS and JavaScript in your project, so you are go ahead to edit something at your local, and after that you upload it again into the server, so the server will take the change. Okay, so now I will have to enter some text into this file. Okay, so after you update the content and the style sheet on this file, so you just close it and open the backend again, and you click on the upload button, select this file, open. Okay, so finally you have to take a look into the date modified here. It is 5th. Click on the upload, and because currently the file has been existing on the server, so you have to check on the, if you don't check on the override, if it file exists, so click on the upload button, it will display a message, a file with the same name it already exists in the target folder, and try it again. Sorry, upload. you have to click on override if the file is exit upload button. Yeah, you can see here the date modified that has been changed to 13. Okay, so now you open the shortcode on this server and open the MVC view readme. Yeah, you can see here the new content of this file has been uploaded into this folder on server. Back to the back end. Okay, so you can see we have upload. Because this feature only limits the file is 200 kilobyte, so it very small. So you have to make sure you don't have some change on a small file. Okay, so you can apply the same thing for another. If you want to have a quick change on the server, in case you don't have the credential to access the server at this time, when you have some urgent task, so you have to use this way indeed, so it will be very faster. Okay, so I hope that helped, and feel free to let me know if you see any issue when working with the file manager in Sitefinity CMS. Okay, bye bye and see you later.